Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. We are looking at the Rockwood 2104S by Forest River. One of the cool features I wanted to mention that this being a Forest River product is Forest River is owned by Warren Buffett, so Berkshire Hathaway company. That's huge for a couple reasons, but one of the huge reasons is because they are debt free, so that you don't have to worry about them going out of business like a lot of guys. About 40% of the industry went out of business a few years ago, back in 08. And so, you know, that eventually will come again, something like that. So if you can get something that the parts are going to be available and warranty is going to be available, that's great. Another cool thing that I like about these guys, they're the number one selling fiberglass trailer in the US. So again, they can buy all their parts for a more competitive price. So once you're the biggest guy in the market, you can remain the biggest guy just because you have the name recognition for market resale availability and things like that. So so let me get started on some specifics about this camper here at the Great Outdoors. This has the vacuum bonded walls. Rockwood's been building campers for about 30 years now. Anything from pop-ups to travel trailers to hybrids to fifth wheels, and all of their campers are vacuum bonded, and they've been around the block a few times, so they know, their engineers know what work and what doesn't work. So, you know, as opposed to a guy who's maybe only been doing it for 5 years, they're still going through the school of hard knocks of trying to figure out what works and what doesn't. Another cool thing that I like about Rockwood is they are one of the few guys that are doing a 2-year structural warranty on their product as well, as opposed to just the 1-year bumper to bumper. So these guys have a 1-year bumper to bumper, two-year warranty on their structure, 12-year warranty on the roof, 5-year warranty on their axles, and again, that experience that they have, that not everybody can say they've been in the industry 30 years, is a huge thing for these guys. Large grab assist handle, LED lighting throughout, including on top of the awning, which uses a lot less energy for your battery. Torsion suspension with the nitrogen filled tires, radial tires, comes with an outside grille. You can put your TV out here, outside speakers, automotive style windows, so you don't have the little piece of rubber here that dries up after a while. So this guy has a spare tire, a ladder so that you can access your roof, which is important if you have a slide out like this one does, so that if you get some stuff stuck on top of the slide out, you can clear that off so that you don't ruin your TPO roof. This TPO roof is nicer than a normal rubber roof. It has a 12-year warranty on it, just like a rubber roof does, but it's more chalk resistant, so it doesn't send black streaks down the side of your camper, as well as it's more resistant to tearing and 30% lighter. So lots of benefits to going to a TPO roof. This does have the MaxAir vent covers over the top of the fans that are on there. That's a huge benefit, so that if you leave those fans open, you don't have to worry about rain getting inside there. 6-gallon hot water heater that's gas electric, direct spark ignition, so you can light it from the inside and you can run it off, both combined together to give you a total of 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. This guy does have an outside shower with hot and cold water running to it, cable satellite, black tank flush so you can flush out your sewer tank from here instead of having to go inside, city water connect, and it has the inlet for the antifreeze to make it really easy to winterize your coach when you need to do that. 30 amp connector with the LED light so you can tell if you have power going to from the pedestal to this spot here specifically. This does have the 12 volt heat pads on the tanks, as well as the elbows protected for the valves, so that if you're in colder weather, the valves won't get stuck open or closed because of super cold weather. This has the rack and pinion system for the slide out system, which has been tried and true for many, many years. It does have some storage underneath here. This is underneath the U-shaped dinette, so you have room for both sides, as well as over here is your fresh water fill, and then you have more storage that you can access underneath the couch that goes all the way across. So if you need to fit those longer fishing poles or something like that, you have it. This guy weighs 4140 dry weight, so that's plenty lightweight to be towable by a lot of your half-ton trucks, as well as even some lighter things than that. This guy does have diamond plate to protect you from the rocks flinging up, as well as an extra light on here, and the power tongue jack so that you can see what you're doing in the dark. The power tongue jack is super nice, especially if you have an equalizer hitch, which I highly recommend. It makes it putting that equalizer hitch on a lot easier, so you're not working through your elbow. Two 20-pound tanks up here, and let's go take a look at a few features on the inside. Another cool feature that I really like about Rockwood is their domed roof. They are going to a domed roof on all their units now, which is a benefit both on the inside and the outside. On the inside, the domed roof makes the unit feel a lot more open. You have more headroom to work with, as well as on the outside, it doesn't allow standing water to just float on top of there and eventually get into your coach. Another huge benefit of how Rockwood builds their roofs are it is a fully walkable roof that's vacuum bonded, as opposed to a lot of other manufacturers that are doing like a wood roof truss system, which is a walkable roof as long as you stay on those studs every 16 inches. So it's not truly walkable. It ends up getting soft spots and things like that. So if you can get a fully vacuum bonded roof like Rockwood, you're much better off. Another huge factor that I really like what Rockwood is doing is they're doing the bow floor in all their coaches. So that makes it slip resistant, mold and mildew resistant, cold crack resistant, which is probably the biggest feature that I really like as opposed to normal linoleum. It's a type of rubbery feel to it that doesn't, if most manufacturers, what they do is they put some glue on the outer perimeter and then put the lino down, and then when it gets cold, it tends to shrink and it wants to pull away, and the middle spot is usually your weakest spot in the camper, and it will put a crack right in the middle of your floor. The bow floor resists that, and it's a lot better. A few other features that I really like about Rockwood is they have gone to a all LED lighted system on the inside and the out. The LED lights are nice because they burn at about 10% of the power that a normal incandescent light works at. They also are a lot brighter, and so that comes into play very importantly when you are working off of a battery that has limited power in it. So if you do something where you're out in the boonies, you don't want to drain your battery just running lights. And also it makes it so that they run a lot cooler. So instead of running at 200 degrees, they run at about 78 degrees. So you're not fighting your air conditioner running the LED lights. Another huge thing that I really like about Rockwood is their max air fans that they put in their campers. That tends to give you a lot more airflow through than the little tiny fan that you usually get up here. The tiny fans give you about 25 cubic feet of air per minute. These max air ones give you over 900 cubic feet of air per minute. So you can open up a window and turn on that fan, and you can create up to a 10 mile per hour breeze through your camper without having to run your air conditioner. That's important because that way you're not running off of a generator or shore power. You can run that all off of the battery. Here specifically at the Great Outdoors RV, our philosophy on how we order in our campers, and specifically even the Rockwoods, is we like to put most of the options that are available to us on the campers. That's how we would want to go camping, instead of the other way, which is, you know, you can strip out all the options and maybe you don't realize that you're missing those options until you're out there camping and saying, oh man, for the extra $200 here and the $200 there, I could have had all these cool options. The problem is a lot of our competition, they will strip out those options, and then you don't know that until after you've already picked up the camper and bought it, and then maybe you saved $800 or $1,000 or something like that, but you're losing out on way more features and benefits than that $1,000 was. Now we're inside the Rockwood 2104S Mini Lite. One of the biggest features on here is the Murphy bed option. I really like this option in this particular floor plan because in shorter campers like this, space matters a lot. And it's hard to find a camper that has a real bed in it and stay the length that this one is at close to 21 foot. This is a heated mattress, so you can control the temperature from 0 to 6 through a 110 power. And then the way that this guy folds up is just push it up. The couch folds up. There is some storage underneath here that you can access from either the outside or the inside, which is pretty nice. And that's it. There's some nice struts on here. You notice how easy it went up and down. That's because the struts kind of help you put it up and down as you're going. You do have some nice storage on both sides, as well as drawers on both sides, and a spot to set your drink. So yeah, just well laid out, and the bed isn't taking up all your space during the daytime when you really don't need it to. Another cool thing I like about this one is the amount of storage it has from the outside underneath the U-shaped, king U-shaped dinette, as well as some nice drawers on both. A lot of guys, they'll skimp on this and they'll put maybe a drawer on one side and then no drawer on the other side, or just a cabinet door. The other thing that's really cool about this area here is they have this U-shaped dinette that has a table that is freestanding, so it doesn't just have the two metal poles that are kind of wobbly. This guy, you flip this little switch right here, and this whole thing right here flips down into a bed really easily. The other nice feature that this guy has is the fabric reverses, and it's vinyl on the other side. So if you have some wet trunks at the lake or spaghetti night or whatever, you're not ruining your fabric that you have on here. It does have extra storage above the dinette here. This has a good sized pantry inside it too, as well as you can use this for extra hanging space too. So they have a bar up here at the top, and then these guys come out if you want to use it not as a pantry, but as just extra closet area. This refrigerator is a refrigerator that runs off both gas and electric, so if you just want to run off your propane tanks because you're out in the woods or whatever, you can do that. Or it can automatically detect when it's plugged into a generator or a campsite power, and it will switch over to that way of keeping the fridge cool. This does have the stone casted sink, even in the Rockwood Mini Lite, which is a sink that has temperatures resistance up to 500 degrees. It's got a lifetime warranty on it. It has the raised faucet here so that you can even put your bigger pots and pans in. It's got the larger oven, the 22 inch oven as opposed to the 17 inch oven. It's got the nice glass top, so you have lots of counter space to work with. So you have a cutting board as well as sink covers, and then this is also flush so that you have lots of room to work, whether you're doing dishes or prepping food. It has a knife rack in the back, as well as it makes for a nice backsplash when you're cooking too. And you'll notice that they put the mini blinds back here instead of the pleated shades so that they're easier to clean. And then throughout the rest of it, they put the nicer pleated shades, the night shades is what they call them. Even in a unit like this, it has a huge drawer underneath here for pots and pans. And so not only do you have the pots and pan sized drawers underneath the dinette, but also in the kitchen itself. And then right here is a little spot to put your scrubby brush or whatever. This does have the RV technology radio on it, so you can put your SD card in it, you can plug into HDMI video in for your aux port, as well as it's a digital thing where you can control both your inside speakers and your outside speakers all in one deal here. Does come with the Furion LED TV built into it. And as you look inside the bathroom here, you'll notice this is a little bit different from the old 2104S's that used to have the curtain as of about 6 months ago. Now they've gone to a nice glass shower top, and it has also the skylight, so you have a lot of natural light to work with. Medicine cabinet in here as opposed to just a mirror. Spot for your soap, your toothbrushes. Just a nice bathroom that they've done, and you notice how I had plenty of headroom to work with in there as well. Thanks for checking out this Rockwood 2104S. Tons of options, everything from the power awning to the solar port. to a rear backup camera ready, large grab assist handle, vacuum bonded construction. Like I said, one of the best floor plans that we have in this size. So thanks for visiting us. Come check out more videos at thegreatoutdoorsrv.com or call us up at 970-313-4337. And if this particular one doesn't match what you're looking for, we have three or four other ones very similar to it. It's just slightly different configured. We'd love to show you those as well.